Hello everyone, my name is Chong Nguyen. I'm a Master Computer Science student, major in cybersecurity. In this master context, I would like to read in a topic that I'm very interested in. It's about vacuum robot security. For introducing the problem, vacuum robot has become one of the most popular IoT devices in American household. I always tell my friend that device looks like a mini Tesla car, because it possesses the hardware, such as LiDAR sensor, AI camera, collision sensor, just like Tesla car does. I could say the vacuum robot is a mobile data collector who can be hacked. And if it got hacked, the user privacy would be affected. Moreover, when looking at cyber hacking, I believe that many of system breach don't need to be performed using a full-scale high-performance computer. It could come from a tiny, small device that we may not be aware of. For example, in the MirrorEye attack that happened in year 2016, it turned 100,000 IoT devices, IP cameras, home routers into bots and used them to attack third-party servers. If you're still unsure about the security of vacuum robot, let's go to the research. Let's go to the research of a group of researchers from Mobile Network Lab. They successfully performed a reverse engineering to reveal a symmetric key that's used to authenticate all needle vacuum robots. Then they can perform stealing attack, data leak attack, and discover the victim IP addresses. Another group of researchers, they resent a side channel attack through a LiDAR sensor, in that they can utilize the LiDAR sensor to catch the sound variation reflected from other objects. Then they use an AI model to detect smoking digits, a credit card, bank account, or social security number. My research will extend the other vacuum robot research by investigating on the security of another random vacuum robot model in the market to explore its vulnerabilities and modeling the attack. I hope that my research will bring awareness to consumers, tell them how to choose and test their IoT device before using them. So next is the approach that I use in my research. I conduct this research with an intelligent vacuum robot that I already own. I purchased this product from Amazon based on the large amount of reviews. It has more than 1,000 of reviews, and the Android application has been downloaded more than 100,000 times. Clearly, if there's a flaw in its ecosystem, it would be a hit to user privacy. And this is a good source for a hacker to weaponize the device to perform a DDoS attack. About the vacuum robot ecosystem, there are three entities: the robot device, the cloud server, and the mobile application. At initial setup, the robot device will send its serial number to the mobile app. In exchange, the mobile app will send back the Wi-Fi credential. The cloud server will perform the binding process that by the username and with the serial number, and store that username serial number mapping in a database. After that, all the control commands made from the mobile app will send to the cloud server and display to the robot device. The map used for navigation is generated by the robot and uploaded to the cloud server. Then it can be downloaded by the mobile application of the cloud server. So after understanding the vacuum robot ecosystem, I began to perform the dynamic analysis using a rooted Android phone, Microxy server. Microxy server access an intermediate server that could monitor, intercept, and fork the web request sent from the mobile app to the cloud. Basically, on those web requests except the binding request, the web request contain only one parameter. This is the robot serial number. I figure out the serial number is a string of the product category concat with model name and a 6-digit number. So in order to get a new serial number, I just need to increase the number in this blue box by one. So as you can see, using a arithmetic sequence to make a serial number, we make the system become vulnerable to a guessing attack. In addition, in an ideal system, after being passed through an authentication module to check access token, there should be an authorization module that check the robot serial number against the username and serial number mapping table to verify the ownership of the user over the robot. However, in this system, this mechanism did not exist. So I could use Mid-Roxy to intercept and modify the serial number to retrieve the data of any robot in the network as long as I use a correct serial number. So locking up defense in depth mechanism, this robot system expose threats that a hacker can use to compromise user privacy and then lead to a zero-day attack. So next is the result of my research. Because of the flaw in authorization, I could bypass the access control and perform many operations on other people's behalf. Those kind of operations would affect all three aspects of the CA trace. If you would like to learn more about the specific detail in each type of attack, read my paper. I also include some remilitary data in that paper. Then I use an stride threat modeling to model the attack and suggest the mitigation. For example, in spoofing, the attacker can guess the serial number and control of the robot, or he can delete the robot map data, gain an unauthorized request, but they may deny that. For information disclosure, attacker can retrieve robot data using a serial number, perform DDoS attack by weaponizing the vacuum robot in the network. Attacker can perform the injection attack to gain privilege. Privilege, right? For mitigation, in all of those kind of threats, the cloud server should apply the server-generated serial number to their robot device to prevent the guessing attack. And for every request that comes through the server, the cloud should check the ownership of the user first by compare against the username robot serial number mapping table. For the challenges that I got in my research, I have to spend time on learning the IoT ecosystem and set up the environment with Mid-Roxy server. There's a time constraint there due to the workflow of all the classes and projects. In conclusion, many IoT devices, including vacuum robots, are built practically that will affect user privacy. Many still confirm lacking a strong access control due to the using of half-coded serial number system and not maintaining IoT device consistency. In the manufacturer side, they should not only focus on designing a beautiful looking robot, but also need to secure their cloud server. Users can protect themselves by inspecting their IoT device carefully before using them. This is a reference that I use in my research. So that would be all about my presentation. Thank you for listening.